বদনে পর নাই প্রকাশ। জয় ভবা, জয় ভবা।
We're in Azimganj, in the banks of the Hooghly, in West Bengal, India. And the reason we're here is because we're about to start a two-week textile residency working with UK and Indian artists to paint silk scrolls as part of a project which is called Silk River. And it's celebrating the relationship between the UK and India, and in particular the communities that are living along the two rivers.
মানুষ দেবতা হয় হয় অবতার।
In Silk River, we are working with 10 communities along the River Thames and 10 communities along the River Hooghly, which is the river that runs into Kolkata. And it's to explore the current connection between Britain and India through the metaphor of the river. So this is the first of the 2 6-day residencies. So in this week we'll make 5, we'll finish them. The artists that are coming to the residency come from different communities who work along with different craft forms. So we have the Patwas, scroll painters, and they tell stories and paint on paper. And then they reveal the scrolls and sing their songs. We have Kanka embroiderers, which is a very well-known technique from West Bengal. We have clay doll painters who kind of paint figurines. And we have Shora artists who do more contemporary painting on ceramics. And we have batik artists, a traditional form of batik from Shantiniketan.
Anyone guess what these lines are?
Vijay River?
That's the river, yeah. So I've drawn the river on each of them, so how the river cuts through the place that you're going to.
And there was this one as well.
We're twinning the Hooghly with the Thames in London.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I actually came, first of all, in November last year. And I went with Ali to all of the 10 locations that we were working with along the Hooghly.
Because originally Barrackpore was about the army barracks.
So I'd spoken to the people in the locations and they had told me what they wanted to be on the banner. So as well as kind of doing the actual creating the banners, one of my roles has been to kind of make sure that we actually include what was said back in November as well as what's the input that we've got this week from the people that we've been working with.
We want on the flag, but also if there's anything else that you think represents that place. And I don't know anything, so you need to help me. If I was going there, what would I see?
My name is Devanjana Bhattacharya, and I'm from Kolkata. I'm now a fashion designing student, and I have doing a course from GFI, Glamour, Fashion and Interiors.
My name is Mongol Hembrom, and I'm from Future Hope, so that's in Calcutta. It's basically an NGO, and which works for like kids who are like underprivileged kids, or like kids who are from the streets or very poor backgrounds.
Right now, I am a fashion designer, and I am doing my business in Garia also. I have my workshop, and I have some stores in contact basis. So I am selling my products with them, and my products is based on basically in embroidery and traditional fabrics, silk, raw silk, handloom fabrics.
We could have like a footpath.
I've been helping with the technical side, setting up the tables, doing the actual techniques of waxing the paper, or the designing obviously first, and then painting, and just keeping control of what's going on, making sure everybody's got something to do and just enjoying what they're doing.
Thank you.
India is very important to me. I first came here in 1984 as a young graduate with a mission to change the world, and but not really knowing how to do it. And I saw the power of arts, which here, every day, every stall that you see on the market, every sari that is wrapped, every floor that is painted is a beautiful piece of work. For me, it inspired me that art was integral to life, and it was also a way of bringing people together. And from that first journey, I have committed the rest of my life to working with communities through the arts. And bringing it all the way to a full circle, if you like, to Salt River, it was amazing to me to discover that here in Murshidabad, it is famous for its salt weaving, and was famous at the time that the British first came here. So it felt, well, this was a really natural point for me to start the narrative of Salt River. In fact, the whole narrative fell into place once I arrived here in Murshidabad.
The Silk River project was introduced to me by Ali when she was in India a year and a half back. And this workshop, the residency that is happening in Murshidabad, is going to be an interesting resurgence of the bonding between the Indian artist and the artist in UK, which was very much alive a few hundred years back. When the Britishers were here, especially during the 19th century and the early 20th century, beautiful silk from Murshidabad were created and sent back to UK. And I see that happening again after over 100 years. So it's a very, very inspiring concept for the development of the artist in India. And I'm sure will be the same to inspire the artist back in UK.
We have some of those with something like this. Behind it. Let's do these first.
At first, make this, and after that?
It's really nice integrating with our different communities. Like from UK, we are beginning to learn new things about UK. We never knew like there were any similarities between River Ganges and River Thames, and now we are beginning to learn those things.
It's a very interesting theme to compare the Thames River and our Hooghly River. The Riverside Silk River Project is doing this. So I'm quite interested to know what is in London Thames Riverside and what is in our Hooghly Riverside. So it's a very interesting how to compare with those rivers and the culture and the social activities also in our flags.
Thank you.
relationship between UK and India goes back a very, very long way. And there's obviously been some difficult times and some challenges, and there's been lots of good things that have come out of that quite challenging relationship. Britain has been here in Murshidabad since the mid-1600s, and there has been trading between the Bengalis and the British for that time. And so there's so much crossing and melding and shared histories that I see it as a kind of very strong, almost family connection. And when I go to Britain, I meet so many people that say, oh yeah, my great uncle was, you know, in the jute mills, or so there's an ongoing connection that is very living today, even, you know, after independence. So I think it's a kind of family bonding, which sometimes you love it and sometimes you hate it, but it's very deep and very special, and we should celebrate that.
This is a Chinese motif look.
Oh, is
but
it?
Now it's look like now it's look like Michelin.
Brilliant.
I don't know.
Privacy. In November, we did workshops with the different communities, and we got the ideas of what should be on each of the flags. And in some cases, we got drawings from the community and the children that we worked with. So we took those ideas and we've selected them for the main things that are needed to tell the story of the place. And then we've scaled them up so that they'll read at a distance. This one, this flag here is Bada Bazaar, which is the main market in central Kolkata. It's where lots of different communities meet. So here we've got the Jewish synagogue, and we've got a Portuguese church, as well as Hindu shrines. And down the bottom of the flag, we've got the sort of trading and the money lenders and the money and the mint. And in between, we've got all the different kind of things that are traded. This then becomes the pattern. And so we can do all our scaling up, and we can make our mistakes, and then we can compose all the different elements, all the drawings from the different participants into the final design. The reason why it's not all in Krishna Gaur history is because of the walk. So the walk is following the line of the river. So in this case, walking has really provided me a space that I really needed. So this is it's a story of this flag. Yeah. In about 2010, I just needed to take a deep breath and go, what is my work now? What is the best way forward for my work? I needed to find some answers to what I should do next. And walking at a distance gave me a space and a rhythm in the rhythm of the walking and the steps, to let thoughts come up organically. Walking in a group, I realised also that the walking is doing all the things that are important to me about my work. It's having a conversation that I wouldn't normally have. I'm meeting people that I wouldn't normally have a conversation with. I'm going to places and observing the landscape in a way that I wouldn't normally do. And so I just thought, I've got one life. I want to do something that I love doing. And so I will incorporate walking into my work. And it's been amazing.
This week we've been making five of the big scrolls, and we've got different artists here, and we've got different students bringing all their various skills and techniques to share. Everyone's been staying together, and we are eating together, trying to talk together, sometimes singing together, and learning about each other's culture and each other's skills and each other's environment and our differences and our similarities.
Dariya mache, dariya mache, biye korate.
Dariya mache, dariya mache. Sing it with me.
Dariya mache, biye korate, jabo lo rongila. Dariya mache, biye korate, jabo lo rongila.
তলে কৃষ্ণ যেমু রলি দিল টান सुने जो तो बगैर गोपी ना धरे पोलान सांझेर बेलाई जो गुनार जो पोलानी ते जान गो राधा घुमो टटानिया ठामू के ठूमू के चले कृष्ण बिनो दिया सांझेर बेलाई जो गुनार जो अंते बोले के सांझेर बेलाई जो गुनार जो
So you can see here that we've got the design underneath here, and then we've covered it with plastic to protect the paper underneath. This silk here is the Murshidabad silk, which is woven locally just north of here in a place called Islampur. It's 100% local, and it's made from the cocoons that are fed on the local mulberry trees at Malda, and it is hand woven. So, and it's, I learned yesterday, it's called triple woven, so it's quite a thick silk, which means it takes the colours really well. And so you can see here that we've now got our clear drawings underneath. This one is the Bharta flag with all these shoes here. And so what we do next is we're going to trace over all these lines with hot wax. I've been painting on silk for 20 years or so. Initially, I felt that I needed to learn something that I could put into my work. I wasn't trained as an artist, and I went to an evening class, and immediately I could see its potential in the way that it takes the colour and the way that it moves. So it's a really fantastic medium for large-scale outdoor performance. The material itself has very special qualities. It's also the medium by which I can engage all aspects of the community. So it really suited my purpose. I mean, my purpose at that point was to get people engaged in making things, beautiful things, to bring communities together. So silk's really been fantastic for me. About here. Mm. So I might as well just finish that one.
Is there a proportion for the colour?
Yeah, so three scoops.
Okay. 3 chamoch dye powder, mix kore, 1 liter rong banana.
And then you put egg to jol
diye.
Aage mist kore.
And then you make a
paste.
Hello.
And his bangle, too. That one.
Hey, Doto.
Yeah.
Over here, everyone seems to be very much experienced, and I feel like we are the ones who are least experienced, so which means we are the ones who are gaining the most. So we are learning a lot of new things. We are learning to work with wax, and I have never worked on this silk before, and so I'm working on that, and which is great, like great fun.
Red and yellow.
What color would they normally be?
I've learnt the value of community, the value of being in an environment with people that are very different to oneself, to learn how we can share and get along and to begin to understand each other. And when you share an activity and you work together, you realize that actually people are very, very willing, very warm, very open. And that's massive value. Wonderful.
Before coming to Future Hope, I was nothing. I came to Future Hope in 2008, 10th May, it was a Saturday. And I particularly remember this date because from that day onwards, my life changed. From that day onwards, I am a different Mongol Hemram. I'm from a very poor family, so I have spent days where I didn't have proper meal. I have spent days like begging. I have also spent days eating foods from dustbins. I didn't have any aim in life. I didn't know what to do. And now I know what to do. Like, I know what I'll have to do. And, you know, I have an aim.
Coming back here this time and really throughout the process of Salt River has been quite a big journey again for me, because I think that I've always known, and people always know about me, that I have a strong connection to India and that it's had a very massive influence on my work and my life. And, you know, people say, oh, well, it's the colour or the vibrancy of your work. But I think it's more than that, and I've only discovered that now. It's more subtle, I suppose. Maybe because I spent a large part of my 20s and my early 30s coming back and forward to India, making things up as I went along. We always used to make these projects up or go on a film shoot, and every day you kind of made up what was going to happen. And then I think I've applied that to my work, and I also have a great confidence that I'll make it up and it will be okay and something will happen. So I think India taught me why I love it is because it's given me some skills and some values that I've really taken with me, and now I've only just realised that it's India that's informed that. Yesterday we were double waxing the scrolls, which means that we had one layer of paint already, and then we put in lots of fine detail into the background and the detail of each drawings. So for example, if somebody's wearing a plain shirt, then you put a pattern on the shirt. And when we're dyeing, those patterns are coming through. So this is the final moment where it all hopefully hangs together. It's a scary moment.
Black
blackcurrant. It's blackcurrant, not black. Well done, everybody. We have now worked together as one team, and I think on every banner when we had a mix, you've done really well. So. We just want to say thank you very much, but we also want to hear from you how you feel about it, what you might have learned, and what you hope for in the next year for the project.
The experience is fantabulous, and this is just mind-blowing experience, and I liked it a lot.
I learned the batik process and dyeing process, and how to works on the fabrics. The how to collage the two different stories, two different culture, how to compare.
Well, I've learned lots of lovely things. I'm a textile artist myself, and some of the things that I've seen that the artists here do are really interesting, and I think I might be able to take some of their ideas back, use them in my own work.
We are learning these things here, and then we'll again be implementing these things at Future Hope. We'll be teaching the kids, so we'll have to learn it properly. And for like my future, I've not yet properly decided, but like I'm studying economics, so probably do something with economics. And at the end of the day, my aim is to become a good human being.
ভয়ে মরে যায়
গঙ্গা হয়ে যায় রবীন্দ্রনাথ জোড়া সাকই পাশে গঙ্গা হয়ে যায়
কলকাতারি রসগোল্লা দেখলে জিবে আসে লালা কলকাতারি রসগোল্লা দেখলে জিবে আসে লালা খেতে ভারি মজা লাগে খেতে ভারি মজা লাগে যদি বিষম নাহি খায়
গঙ্গা হয়ে যায় রবীন্দ্রনাথ জোড়া সাকই পাশে গঙ্গা হয়ে যায়
মার্বেল প্যালেস পায়রা বাসা ঘুরে ফিরে দেখতে আসা মার্বেল প্যালেস পায়রা বাসা ঘুরে ফিরে দেখতে আসা না দেখিলে মেটে না আশা না দেখিলে মেটে না আশা মন মজে যায়
গঙ্গা হয়ে যায় রবীন্দ্রনাথ জোড়া সাকই পাশে গঙ্গা
These flags are canvases where stories are illustrated. I love them because they're a means by which you can gather a narrative from whoever you're working with and translate that into abstract patterns and drawings. And then I edit it and compose it so that it has some kind of narrative, and people get very attached to that. And then when you take them on a walk, if you say, we need to get this flag 100 miles down the river, people get very attached to carrying them. And then obviously if they've got their drawings on it, they feel a real sense of ownership. I think it certainly gives people a common purpose which transcends class barriers or racial barriers. If you're there painting a 6 meter scroll, colouring in silk, that is the common purpose. And while you're having that as a common purpose, then a dialogue happens that wouldn't normally happen. But I always say that my work is about enabling a dialogue to happen that wouldn't normally happen, that may change people's perception of who they are and who other people are. And if it overcomes fear of the unknown, then for me that is what we need to overcome in the world. We need to overcome fear of the other.
I'm very happy that this whole initiative conceived between Ali and myself is coming to reality. These 10 flags will be up on the as a backdrop of the stage, and the British High Commissioner would actually launch them to inspire the audience during the Murshidabad Heritage Festival.
Together. Silk, the flag painting, the communities and the arts and India, all together into one really kind of long project. If you can do that, if you can establish one project that also enables many different communities to do projects within the project and to empower people on that scale, then surely that is a model that you could apply elsewhere, which might hopefully be of some use in this rather troubled period of life.
Hindu.